time I have a show. I sell it off, I go to sleep. We got some new bands, we got some new bands, yeah, yeah. We got some new bands, we got some new bands, yeah, yeah. Treating these D.O.s like this shit's old vans, yeah, yeah. I fuck that little bitch, told her just bring her friend, yeah. Alright, what is going on, guys? It's your boy Jamie, and I'm back with another banger. Today's video, we got top 10 back to school shoes under $200. Now, I know back to school shoes are getting very, very expensive, but I'm trying to keep it budget friendly for you guys. I know with quarantine and everything going on, sneaker prices have just been jumping up lately, but I'm trying to help you guys out, trying to help you guys find some good sneakers that'll still be stylish, fashionable. I know back last year I was able to do it for under, what was it, $100 or $150, but with everything going on, there's no way that I could get one, an entire list under $100. $200 should be a decent budget for you to get a nice clean pair of shoes for school. So I'm just started off simple, and then we're gonna get, you know, into more of like the more expensive stuff. So the cheaper side, we're gonna start with number one. We're gonna go with the Vans, and I'm always gonna put the Vans in the list every year because Vans are so simple, so stylish, so clean. They're timeless. They never go out of style, man. You could always wear a pair of Vans. You could literally buy a basic pair of Vans, or you could buy a pair of Vans and customize them like I did with my Off-White Vans, like I showed you guys in my sneaker collection. You know, there's so much stuff you can do with Vans. There's literally anything and everything you can put your mind to. There's so many custom videos on how to customize Vans on YouTube. You can just literally look it up and go customize it, or you could just wear it the way it is, because there's so many different colorways and options for Vans. Vans are just like timeless, man. They never go out of style. Same thing with the Air Force Ones, which is number two. The Air Force One is the exact same thing. You can customize it, make it your own, make it look super cool. There's so many videos on that. Or you could just wear it the way it is. There's the white and the black in case you want to just be simple, or you could buy some of the crazier ones, some of the ones that have a whole bunch of different colors: red, blue, white, black, yellow, purple, and literally anything. So many different options, and they're super cheap. All of them should be at least under $120. Next shoe is going to be the Revenge Storm by Ian Connor. Now, these are gonna be a little bit harder to find. You could probably find them on eBay, OfferUp, Facebook. You're gonna have to look around because you're not gonna find these in the store at all. Probably not even on GOAT or StockX. They actually both stopped selling those because they couldn't differentiate between the real and the fake pairs. But just be careful when you're buying them. Be sure to watch a real versus fake video, you know, stuff like that. Be able to educate yourself. Just be careful when you're buying those. They are a nice shoe though. They're like Vans, but they have the lightning bolt on the side, so it's a little bit different. And they also don't make half sizes, so you're gonna have to know, you know, what size fits you better, you know, things like that. So try on a couple different pairs of shoes before you buy those so that you know exactly what size you need to get. But super nice, super stylish shoe. There's a lot of different colorway options for those as well. Usually you should be able to get them for less than $200. So yeah, the Air Jordan 1 satin black gym red, whatever you call it, I'm not sure what to call it. I believe these are still sitting on shelves in stores, so you could walk in and probably buy it for like $100, but if not, go StockX. All the different aftermarkets, they're all selling them, so you can get them for cheap. I believe they're still under retail. You should be able to get them for less than $160, no matter where you find them. But it's a nice, clean, simple black and red shoe. You can never go wrong with black and red. It's super simple, easy combination to be able to match basically every single outfit you have. So that's why I put those in there. And Jordan 1s are super stylish. Everybody's loving the Jordan 1s. So I thought I had to throw in a pair of Jordan 1s just to, you know, help you guys out, start up your Jordan 1 collection. Next shoe is going to be the Jordan 5 Top 3. Now this is a little bit more pricey, and it is also a little bit more tasteful. I know not everybody likes the Jordan 5, but if you do like the Jordan 5, it's a really nice colorway. I personally wouldn't wear it myself, but it is a nice colorway. It's mostly black, so you can match it with a lot of different things. And then it has the purple hits. I'm not looking at it, so I'm just trying to think off the top of my head, but it has the purple, the blue, and then it has red as well, I believe. So it has a couple different colors on there that you can match with different outfits and things. I believe on GOAT they're selling for around $230, so it's a little bit pricier, a little bit over $200, but you should be able to find a used pair
for less than $200, you could probably find a used pair for a really good price if you guys are into buying used shoes. If not, then look around on eBay and places like that, and you should be able to find a brand new pair for a little bit less than what GOAT and StockX are selling them for. The next shoe is going to be a Jordan 3, and the Jordan 3 is a super, super easy shoe for anybody to wear. It's like the Jordan 1. Basically, anybody can pull off the Jordan 3. So basically, the colorway is going to be the Jordan 3 Unite. Right here. So it is that all red one. I know not everybody liked it when it came out. If you don't like it, you can obviously paint it black, customize it, make it look like the Black Cement 3. I've seen a lot of people do that. But if not, you can just wear it red, and I'm pretty sure everybody has some red in their wardrobe, so they can obviously match it with anything, you know, black, white, red, gray, things like that. But it's a really nice shoe. I don't know why people hate on it. I really like it. I think it's super underrated. I feel like it's one of those shoes that a year or two from now will probably be super expensive. I really like it. You could probably find it on Go. I just looked, and I believe you could find it for less than $170. So you should be good on that. Depending on the size, you might have to spend closer to $200, but it should be still under that $200 mark. And if not, you can buy them used and get them for a much better price. The next shoe is going to be the Jordan 5 Belair. Now, these just dropped, I believe, a couple days ago. I don't know. I wasn't really paying attention to them because I didn't like them like that. But I know a lot of people like them. This is more of an out there shoe. This is also one of those more tasteful shoes, you know. Not everybody likes to stand out, but this is a shoe that's definitely gonna make you stand out. I know most of it is like gray, but it has all those little pops of color that can really help you stand out if that's what you're trying to do this school year. So that's why I included it on the list. It's kind of like a flashy shoe, but at the same time not. I think it's probably one of the most flashy shoes on this list. I knew I had to include at least one of those, so I thought I might as well include this one. Since they just dropped, I believe they're sitting around 230, but I think they'll probably go down in the next week or two and then probably jump back up. So if you want to buy them, probably wait until maybe a week from now and then start buying them. But even still, you could buy a used pair and probably save a lot of money. So yeah, the next shoe is going to be the Alternate Grape 5. And I know I've put three pairs of Jordan 5s in here, but they've been dropping a lot of Jordan 5s this year. And this one is a purple one. So this is another one of those out there shoes. I know not everybody, you know, has purple in the wardrobe or likes purple, but for those people that are wanting to stand out, like I said with the Belair 5s, this is one of those shoes that'll help you stand out. Like, it's purple. Not everybody is, you don't see everybody wearing purple all the time. So it's one of those out there shoes that anybody can, you know, pull off. It's the same, it's gonna be around the same price point as the Jordan 5 Top 3s and the Belair 5s, hovering around that 230 mark. But you can find a good used pair for cheap. Just check eBay, Facebook, places like that, and you can find a really good pair for a good price. We're gonna move on to the next shoe, and I know I have a lot of Jordans on this list, but that's basically, you know, what my subscribers wear, what they have. So if you want me to make a part two with a bunch of different other shoes, then I will make a part two. Just get this video to, I don't know, like 20 likes. The next shoe is gonna be the Jordan 12 University Gold. Now, I absolutely love this shoe. It's black and yellow, super, super easy to pull off. Not a lot of people wear yellow either, but if you're trying to add some yellow into your wardrobe, I feel like this is a good shoe to do it with because it has black. So you can literally wear it with all black. You can wear it with black, white, neutral tones, and it'll look good. Yeah, it's a super simple, easy shoe to add some yellow into your collection. It's gonna give you a little bit of pop just because that yellow is like really, really, it's a really nice shade of yellow. It really pops out at you. But not a lot of people like the 12s, but I feel like this is one of those 12s colorways that's like so good that you just have to buy it. You know what I mean? I still haven't bought my pair, but I will be buying a pair soon. I believe these are hovering around the 230, 240 mark, which is a little bit more pricey, but you can find some good used pairs for good prices. When I was reselling them, I found some good used pairs for like 180, 170, you know, around there. So you can still find them for under $200, which is why I included it in the list. And the next shoe is gonna be the Jordan 11 Low Concord Bred. Now, this one also is hovering around $230. But like I said, the used pairs are gonna be your best friend when it comes to buying these kinds of shoes, because used pairs, people will wear them once and they're automatically like $50, worth $50 less, man. So buying used shoes really, really helps you save money. It's white, black, and red. You really can't go wrong with that. So that's all 10 shoes, but I did want to give you guys two bonus shoes just because I know I put a lot of Jordans in here. Not everybody wears Jordans. So I wanted to put a couple other ones in here. So I got the VaporMax Plus and the VaporMax Flyknit. So those two shoes are pretty much the same thing, not exactly the same thing, but super nice shoes, super easy to pull off, and you can find them for under $200 basically anywhere you look, man. But it's a really nice shoe, super easy to pull off. And I've heard they're really comfortable. I've never had a pair myself, but I've heard they're comfortable. So that's why I included it in the list. And that's going to be about it for the list and the entire video. So if you guys enjoy, if you guys want a part two, let me know down below. And I'll put a bunch of different, you know, a whole bunch more variety, because I feel like I put too many Jordans in here. But that's basically all that's been releasing this entire year. So I don't know, I wouldn't know what else to put in here. So yeah, that's just gonna be about it for the video. So if you guys did enjoy, leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.